Hello, my YouTube fans and friends, and everybody else who watches this video. This video I'm making because I just had a nervous breakdown, kind of an emotional breakdown. It's a little hard to explain why I had it. First let me start off by telling you a story, a true story, or something that's been going on in the past few days. Okay, so as you can see, I have a nice new haircut, all fresh and everything. Got a nice design and the beard and stuff. You know, they got the relevant to the story, but it's actually not. When I was at the barber shop, the barber who was doing this stuff, I had a suspicion that they were gay. I don't know why, I just had this instinct, this gut feeling that, you know, this person could be gay. There was stuff about eye contact. You know, I looked at the guy and kept looking at me. He kept looking at me and he was showing me things. He had a flyer for a Ricky Martin concert on his mirror, the barber mirror or whatever. Oh, yeah, and, you know, he was really smiley, like, you know, teasing a lot while he was talking to me. I don't know, I just got this vibe. Like, I just had this feeling, like, I think he's gay, even though it's not obvious that he's gay. And I think maybe I took this a little too far. After my haircut got done, I asked him his name, and I couldn't really understand what he was saying completely because he had a really strong accent, so, in fact, he doesn't speak he doesn't speak much English, he only speaks Spanish, mostly, and so I just asked him to, you know, write it down, and he wrote his name down, and he also wrote his number, but I didn't ask for his number. So that also gave into that feeling that I had. And so, you know, I'm attracted to this guy, and there's all these things that I'm interpreting as signs that he's gay. You know, I guess, you know, it's kind of, you know, I'm always trusting in, like, the whole gaydar thing. So, I leave out of the place with a smile on my face, not just because I got a good haircut, but because I believe that I had found out that a guy that I liked was gay. Just a while ago, I texted him. I started asking questions. And first I said, hey, is this such and such? I'm not going to say their name, but I said, hey, is this such and such? And they were like, yeah, who's this? And I told him who I was. He was like, remember you, and I was like, oh, well, you cut my hair yesterday, you know, you did my design and everything, and, you know, after you were done, I asked you for your name, and you gave me your name and your number on paper, so I left the house. And then he said, oh yeah, I remember. Okay, and so I said, well, I just wanted to test and make sure that I added the number right and to also say hello. And I put a little winking emoticon in the text too. Kind of like give a hint. I didn't get a response back after that. There was no text after that, and it was a while. And it was just bugging me. And so I just said to him, it's something I want to ask you, but I'm afraid to. And he said, okay, what? And I asked him, or I said to him, it's gonna sound funny. And then he just said, okay, again. Okay, it stands for what, if you don't know. And so I asked the question. I asked, are you attracted to other men? He said, I'm attracted to women, okay. That's a good response. Yeah, I found out that I was wrong the whole time. And, now I'm a little afraid. So weird, I'm afraid. If I just disclose to this person that I'm gay, and this person is not gay, and now they obviously know that I was attracted to them. And I'm scared that this person might be homophobic, I don't know. Or maybe he'll tell all the other barbers in the barbershop that, you know, what happened, that I texted him, asking him this question, and, you know, they tell them that I'm gay, and that they might, I don't know, I'm thinking all kinds of things, like, I'm thinking it to the farthest extent, like, I'm scared to go back to the barbershop now, and that's my favorite barbershop, I want to go back, but now I have a fear inside me. Because I've heard all these stories about gay people getting killed and winding up gay and horrible things. So, I just thought I should post a video about this, so we had to get it out. I'm afraid. You know, one part of me wants to just be who I am and do what I do. What I would typically do and just go to that barbershop because I like the fucking barbershop. And the other part of me is afraid that this guy might try to, you know, beat me up, pull a gun on me, pull a knife on me, you know, gather some friends that are also homophobic. I mean, that's assuming if he is homophobic, you know, it's crazy. I feel like I shouldn't have to go through this. And I feel like no gay person should have to go through that. And I didn't realize that there's probably so many gay people going through that until now, when I'm sitting here and feeling the anxiety, no worry. So, bad move on my part, I guess. I was testing the waters. actually surprised you guys might know. Like, I really thought it was, you know, I'm actually surprised. But that's besides the point. The point is now, he said he's straight. I'm afraid he's also homophobic. I'm afraid. It's a fear. I'm an anxious person, so I worry a lot. And I just want to know what you think. Leave me some comments, please. I love hearing from you guys. Gotten a lot of comments, a lot of views on my Friends That I Have With Me video, and you guys are awesome. And I appreciate your feedback. Okay. I'm gonna cut this video now because it's starting to get, you know, to its maximum amount of time. So yeah, just give me some comments, alright? God bless. God bless you all. Love you all. Take care.